Away from that, health centers providing vaccination within Gulu City have been directed by Gulu City COVID-19 Task Force Chairperson Odongpini Dennis to vaccinate everyone eligible to receive the COVID-19 jab. This comes after it emerged that some vaccines meant for the target population could expire due to low uptake. Here's more.
We have this vaccine, the Sinovac, which was ring-fenced mainly for teachers. I'm reliably informed that we still have some of this vaccine which have not yet been used.
In a bid to save the COVID-19 vaccines from expiring, the Gulu City Task Force Chairperson has directed for the vaccination of people above 18 years interested in receiving the jab. The Task Force Chairperson fears that some drugs will expire due to the low acceptance by the target population.
If we don't also get, we don't get enough of that category, then instead of the medicine expiring, we can vaccinate other Ugandans resident in Gulu City who wish to be vaccinated, because we are expecting a bigger consignment of vaccine this week.
In the second phase of the vaccination exercise, the government of Uganda put emphasis on the elderly and teachers, but the turn-up for the jabs has been demoralizing to the Gulu City Task Force members.
Keep up sensitizing them and keep them knowing the time of vaccination, the day we always, if could be given over the radio. Such a day, there's massive vaccination, such a places. Would help so much.
The country continues to receive more doses of the various vaccines such as AstraZeneca, Sinovac, Johnson & Johnson and others. A section of the task force members are also calling for churches within the city to be transformed into vaccination sites.
If the committee can recommend churches to be used for vaccination sites, it will give us as a plus service and additional services to the people, and the catchment will be okay. And I don't think whether we shall register any vaccine to expire if we use churches and markets.
The 201 million shillings that were allocated to the task force has finally been received. However, the task force has failed to utilize the money which was sent to the areas that were annexed from the neighboring districts of Omoro, Gulu and Nwoya due to lack of clear jurisdiction.
The money which is still there in the division, they should not use it until when the task force, they plan how to use that money.
Meanwhile, the police has pledged to intensify curfew hour operations. Since Sunday, the 26th of September 2021, over 36 workers have been arrested. The suspects were arrested from Philip Turner Road, Custom Corner, and Laibi Roundabout.
Around the neighborhood, brought them to CPS Gulu, and upon interrogation, most of them self-confessed their sex workers. And of course, we had to screen them because they were not basically found loitering in the streets, but they were found congregating in illegal drinking points. And of course, also in the same category, we managed also to apprehend over 20 men.
I am Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.